as swift as a swallow, she flies through the air. You may travel the country, but none could compare with the pride of the Creggan, that bonny white hare. One fine Sunday morning, as you may suppose, a red golden sun o'er the green mountain rose, Barney Conway came down and did loudly declare, today I'll put an end to that Creggan white hare. So he searched through the lowlands and down through the glens, among the green rushes where the white hare dens, till at last come it over the bog bank so bare, from behind a white thistle out jumped the white hare. Well, he gave a great yell that his dog she slipped to, as swift as the wind o'er the green mountain flew. But the dog soon came back, which made poor Barney sigh, for he knew that the white hare had bid him goodbye. We have some jolly sportsmen down from the Pomeroy, cooks down on Gannon and also the Moy, with pedigree greyhounds they came from afar, came down to the Creggan in the fine motor car. Just down through the lowlands these huntsmen did go, to search for the white hare they tried high and low, till at last Barney Conway, as he came on its lair, shouted out to the huntsmen, here lies the white hare. So they called in their greyhounds from off the green lea, and Barney and the huntsmen they jumped high with glee. And on the turf bank they all gathered around, seven men and nine dogs did the poor hare surround. No wonder the poor puss did to ramble with fear, she stood on her hind legs, she rose her big ear, she rose on her toes, and with one gallant spring cleared over the greyhounds and broke through the ring. Oh, the chase it went on, it was a beautiful view, as swift as the wind o'er the green mountain flew. But the pedigree motor car. And now to conclude and to finish my rhyme, I hope you'll excuse me for wasting your time. If there's any amongst you in Carrickmore fair, drink a jolly good health to the Creggan white hare.